Hey everyone, it's Dave, Display Fireworks One. It's the Saturday after the July 4th holiday. I'm in a town right outside of Chicago, Illinois. And we're doing a fireworks display for a privately held ATF license holder. This gentleman followed my videos, got his ATF license, has a magazine, has a permit for today. On this private piece of property he has, where you see how beautiful this is when we take a look around. We're shooting around $7,000 worth of product from Lynch Imports. We're using the Cobra wireless firing system tonight, and we're throwing in a few other things, including my cakes, Academic Pyro and Pyro Dave. This gentleman's a fan of my videos. He was kind enough to buy these products to have here, and we're going to open with it tonight, which is great. So, and even provided the help for me to help shoot this show. His family pitched in with him, put this together, contracted with me to come out and shoot it. That's some of the details. Come on, let's take a look. I'll show you his magazine too later. Check out this piece of property. It's beautiful. Nice on a lake. People across this lake are going to get one hell of a show. Now, normally he would do the show over the years with just cases of Excalibur canister shells, hand lit, this sort of thing. Not to this magnitude. Now, I apologize for not getting this sooner, but when I come to a show, I bring the rain. And it almost rained, so we're playing it safe. But before we cover everything up, I want to show you some of the product. Come on. We're working quite a few different positions on the Cobra. Before I can get into this finale, I want you to take a look at it. It's all Lynch Import stuff. Lots of boom, lots of color. Thunder Kings over here. Display cake. And here's the best part. He gave me permission to kind of put it together. I said, get two of everything. We're going to fire two of everything. So it's going to be like a Lynch Import demo, only more intense and faster. And of course, right here, the Rolling Thunder, 10-second cake. Four of these babies, right here, four. Everything's big, big cakes. Cake shit. All right. Isn't this a nice piece of property? Has his own magazine over here. I'll have to show it to you. All right, let's take a look. Hey Pat, raise your hand up so everyone knows who you are.
How's it going?
It's Pat, the owner of the property here. He and his family put this show together. But see, we got a little mix of everything. We got all the cakes in here. We're going to mix in some consumer stuff. We got some Excalibur shells. Here's the Cobra. Kind of playing it safe in case it rains. Come on over here. This is, if I remember right, it's code. I can't tell you the code, okay? But it salutes. When we put this show together, he said, I got how many, what do you see over here? I got all these pipes. You know, what should we put in it? I go, do you have a permit? Yes or no? Yeah, we do. Then we're putting salutes in it. So here it is right here. This is, racks already built in the trailer. Like I said, here, you want to get a little closer look here. 3-inch mortars. We're going to load these up. And over here, this is something you can do too. They're huge. Look at the size of these. And this thing is full. Well, I don't like the looks of that. There's no label. Right here. Canister salutes. Always be sure it's all fast fused. All the ends. We just have to figure out how we're going to connect it together. We're going to fire it on a firing system. How many do we have here, Tom?
Two cases. 389.
389.
389
Yes.
389 canister shell salutes. And I'm just going to rip them. I'm gonna light both ends of them. We're just going to rip it.
We're going to rip it, man.
We got quick match. We got everything. Okay. Over here. See, you keep going to business, you wonder where you get these orders from, right? They're from my people, okay? Alright, so when I get you to sign up on my website, you're going to know. I'm going to show you the magazine he got. Okay, he paid to have a magazine put in on his property. I'll try and show you that before it's over. A whole bunch of Cobras, but we're not going to use them all. So we're going to have two of everything. So two Cobras on the same channel. When I fire number one, two number ones are going, two number twos, two number three. It's going to be intense for such a piece of property. All right, this is what we're looking at so far. So everything's probably going to be covered up pretty soon. We almost had a rain, and then it went over us. His dad looked at the radar, said it's going to be good, but we can't take any chances. All right, that's where we're at so far, and I'll cover more as we go. All right. Okay, we're back. Just to bring you up to speed, we started early. Here's the thing. Everything you see here fit in his magazine, and I'll show you that as we get moving here. And they're even amazed it all fit, but it did. We're coming to the end. I'm trying to come up with a finale to where we have the Rolling Thunders, we have the 3-inch salutes, and we have the canister salutes. So I'm thinking maybe, I was going to end in the Rolling Thunder, but then I said no. Maybe start with that Rolling Thunder, and as it's rolling, move into the canister salutes, double fused, and then finish the whole show off with the 3-inch salutes. It's tough here because the audience, this is all his property here, and the audience is going to be here. But at the same time, a lot of the V-cakes, I have to put this way. So these people across the lake here are going to get a hell of a show. We're worried a little bit about the fallout because this at one time used to be a Christmas tree farm. So there's a lot of pine trees and this kind of stuff on the ground. The upside is it rained for a lot of days. But I think we should be okay. So let's come on over and look. Breaking in Pat's Cobras here tonight. We have everything numbered. Yeah, come on, let's take a look over here. We can see how we did some of this. Forgive the wind, please. Okay, what I'm gonna do here is probably run some quick match in amongst this, just light this whole thing at one time.
Got one for you here, Patrick. Okay, I need to take
it. You see, when you do a Cobra show like this, everything becomes a number. So it's mod 3, Q4, then it's left and right.
Randall!
Randall. I mean, they're all experts here.
Randall.
See? They taught them how to put it in, put the electric match in. So we heard the threat of rain has passed. So we're going to take a chance now and not cover everything.
You got the tape and tape down the flaps so they're not sticking out.
See, that Cobra equipment looks too new. We have to break it in.
We're going to break it in.
We're going to break it in, Pat.
Sounds good.
Yeah. See, he has the... Here, I'll show you the upside of having, come on in, watch the wires. See the upside of buying the Cobra external shell, it's channeled right here. See that so the wires,
that
if we want, we can close it in like this. And it screws in external antenna. So we're gonna just fire with buttons, one at a time. I'm pretty lucky because I'm staying at a hotel like less than 2 miles from here, so it's kind of fun. it's in his trailer, it's pretty stable. We're gonna fill this up with salutes, and it should already be chained. Yeah, I'm gonna teach you guys how to drop them and how to connect one to the other, and this will be the final cap on the knife. So this is you'd probably pay, who knows, maybe 20 grand for a show like this professionally. And it's about 7 grand, or a little over $7,000 in product. And that's 7,013 product. And that's quite an amount of money. So quite an amount of product, I mean, for that money. But I mean, it's a hell of a deal.
Patrick, two more for you.
So we got a lot of Boom, a lot of Thunder Kings, which is my complaint when I do a pro show, is there's never enough Boom in it. You know, I want a lot of Boom. So hopefully everyone's happy with the Boom.
You got eight?
Now, I got to get up here to show you that magazine, so maybe we could see if we could squeeze that in somewhere. All right, everyone, I'll get back to you. Okay, everyone, learning opportunity, because no one teaches it. I'm going to teach it to you here, and they told me, and I don't want you to make this mistake. Come on.
Okay,
so the red.
Okay, here, no matter what I do here, first let me talk about this, because the Chinese people are on Facebook and watch my videos. Stop putting that Visco fuse on these damn finales, okay? Because I gotta tear it all off to chain this thing together. There's still people that hand like these things. Unless, why the people that import these keep asking for Visco fuse on finale chains, I don't know. But I wish it was just black match, because I can connect this stuff a lot quicker. All right, now that I did that. They made a mistake here and they don't mind me showing it to you, because, and I'm glad they told me. It all looks the same, but they built this from Home Depot black pipe. And I'd have never picked up on it until they told me, because it looks so similar. I don't want you to do that. This black pipe is not the same as this black pipe. You want the high density plastic. You have to spend the money to get those mortars, no matter how you do it. Don't go to Home Depot and do this thinking it's the same pipe. If something blows apart in this, it's going to shatter. And it's going to send shrapnel everywhere and hurt someone. It's just not worth it. You may be able to shoot out of it, and it'll work 100 times, and 101 it won't, or the first time something blows apart, it's no good. When this something blows apart in these, particularly salutes, it's going to swell, and it won't go into shrapnel. All right, that's our little learning opportunity there. And don't go and use that white pipe either at Home Depot, because it's going to do the same thing. All right, everyone, a learning opportunity. Hey, everyone, we're putting together some of the finale strings. Some are single shots. We're trying to get rid of it. See, Visco, we don't want that. We're going to cut that off, and then we're going to cut into this quick match to expose the black match. This is the 5-strand black match, and then we're going to get one big piece of quick match and put this whole thing together just to get rid of these singles into the finale. So I just cut right alongside and expose it. It's black match when it's in there, and then when you cover it, it's quick match. So it's like electricity. One big piece of current we're going to send through all of it. And it doesn't take much.
Patrick, which ones do you want to stake?
I think you start making.
And then I have to connect all this finale the hard way, because someone put Visco on. Right? No matter what I say, that's going to happen forever. Anything extra, throw it in the pipe. Okay, it's exposed. Here's the quick match. And it's the good stuff, okay? At least I hope it's the good stuff. If it ain't, I'm gonna be mad. Let's see. I don't like it. I don't like it. See it? What color does that look like to you? Now. Come look at the difference in color. Yeah.
Gray and black.
It could be that perchlorate, and my guess is it is. Okay, I need a tape man.
Uh-oh.
Huh? Uh-oh. Oh, here we go with the tape.
Uh-oh. We've been on it all day.
Come on, Richie
now.
Rich.
Stop now.
Let's see. We'll start. We got to figure a way to connect all of these. I need to think of a way to do it. A couple ways to do it. Let's see. Let's put, here, give me a piece of tape. All right, come over here, Haley, so they can see. I'm going to put three together and tape it. Like this. Okay. See how I'm doing that, Rich?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Come over here, Haley. I'm going to start cutting. Then I'm going to run jumpers. May not even need to expose it. Man, I'm upset. I'm upset about that quick match. Hey, it's in disguise. People don't even know. It's in disguise. Well, you got get Uncle Lou's duct tape or electric tape. Here's a contraption for you. So you, if you're new at this, so you could unplug it and put an electric match in it, goes back in. See, visco again. Okay. Do it all in singles. Always check your electric or your quick match before you buy it. They may not even know they have that. Because that's normally I would see that on red and blue external wrappings. This is the first time I ever noticed it on this more of a traditional cover. Okay, Rich. Oh, you're getting it, brother. You're catching on, man. I'm going to hire you. You're getting it. See, these guys are learning quick. You know, when I came here, he brought me some good help. Okay. Good. Lots of wind now. We almost have rain. Okay. And what to do is cut to where... We don't have to expose it as much as I did, but I cut it a little slit on it, on the side. See, some of it's already exposed. God, that looks like gray on that. There it is there, it's on a shell. See? Some were black matte, some were gray. Stop using that. Stop putting that stuff. Now, it may work where you're just transferring fire down into the shell. But see, when you want to use it like quick match in another application, like we're trying to do, I don't like it. Okay. All right, Rich. See, can you put four together again?
Okay.
And then bring the ends up.
Okay.
To where that exposed end is all lined up good.
Okay.
Because I'm going to put a little wrapper. That's it. Here, let me see. Wow, it's falling apart. This is junk. See, some of these shells are no good. Here, we're going to cut it here.
Yeah. See,
it's falling apart.
That. Yeah. This is fine.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah. Here, watch. Now you got to be careful with it, right? Mm-hmm. This is perchlorate.
Black, gray, black, gray.
Some are black. Yeah, we got, all of that has to be where none of it's exposed. Okay, well anyway, we're gonna go through and do this. I won't burden you with watching us do it all. And then I'm gonna run jumpers through them and try to just fuse them all up with the quick match. And then over here, what I have to do, may as well take a look. Yeah, it's black. It's black. It's good. This one's black. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll put these two together with some tape, etc., and daisy chain the finale. I'm going to show you here. See, it's visco. That's stuff's worthless for this application. So we're going to cut into it. Cut. Cut. Think of it like electricity. You know, that since we're not going to be moving, I'm just going to go without a bucket. See, touch like this. Now, you have to see how it's just all together. This is where the magic tape shines, buddy, right here. Want to seal it up good?
Because that's all the chain, right?
Like this. And tape. Now this, we're just, see, it's now we're connected. And then we're going to go back over there, and I think I did. I may have jumped that one already. So here I'm going to jump this one over here. Well, see, I could skip this fuse or take this one. You know, either one. Say I want to do it here. Let's cut it. See what it looks like. It's looks good. See, I'm gonna tell you what else they do. They'll get that perchlorate and they'll put charcoal in it. Hey, can I get some tape? I don't know if they did that here, but this looks like good black match. Magic tape. So we'll go through it. Okay. Jump it. Okay. That's a little bit right there. Now we have this whole thing fast fused here. This is the 2-inch solutes, they call it, but it's really like 1.91 or whatever it is. It's the same size as the canister artillery shells. And I put all the quick fuse here, put some the so-called black match in this little bucket penny wrapper. I'm going to take the electric match, put it right here. So this, see, when you put an electric match in, look at that real close. See that? See those layers of paper? You don't want to go here. You want to get right into it. See right where it is. And go there. And then put a slip knot, tie it. Now you have to watch because fire can still get in that little opening and close it. So now, if we did this right, this whole thing should light right here. These guys fused it all, they did a good job. And if any one of them makes it over to the other end first, it's going to double light it. and it'll send the fire up the other way. So this whole thing now is on one electric match. And then we're going to do the same thing over there with the 3-inch finale. So I just wanted to show you that. And you bring all the fuse up. We have to foil this because this fuse here may be prone to like side ignition. If something lands on it, we could lose it. So we'll have to foil this thing. All right, there it is.
That Heron didn't like that very much.
Whole thing's on one electric match. All right. Okay, the temperature's dropping. They looked at the radar. They don't think there's going to be any rain. Here's the finale. I'm going to hit it in two spots. I'm going to hit it here, and I'm going to hit it here. One of the wires goes to this module, and then I put an extension on the other one and take it to this module. We're firing two of everything at the same time. Now, we only have one number 9 hit, so I don't mess my continuity up. In my mind, I put just an electric match on number 9 here because I'm running two mods on the same channel. So I'll show continuity and that electric match will just pop. So it's going to end in all 3-inch salutes. The Rolling Thunder, the canister shells. And the Rolling Thunders are pretty quick. I think it was 10 seconds. So I'm going to be rolling some thunder. And then I'm going to roll some canister shells, which is probably going to be slow now that I think about it. But it's all fast fused and it's double fused. That if it, the first one that makes it across will light all the other ones. So it's all like, it's going to hit here and go across and then burn this way. And here, I jumped it in a couple places. And see, here's what you got to watch. When you build these display chains were in 12s. This is built into 10s. 10s this way. So we had to start improvising. I don't know. Somebody asked me, why do they do that? Why are some 10? Why are some 12? One day someone's going to make display product that's geared towards not a big display company, but the backyard enthusiast. Dennis Lynch is hitting on that a little bit, and he always did with the cakes that come 2-1 and 4-1 and occasionally 8-1. But like these are all big display company kind of cakes right here, these. So see, I gotta watch these guys, see where they stay. See, you gotta watch if there's an angle. This is straight up. See, I'm working with all relatively they're experienced with backyard but not pro stuff, so I want to go through and double check a lot of what they do. But they did great. They really did. And I keep wanting to show you that magazine. So maybe we'll take a walk up and look at that. We're down by the magazine. You know what's funny? Some of these companies that advertise with me, when I go to like renew, I'll say, hey, how am I doing for you? Is being part of my website and what I do? Oh yeah, we got a couple people from you and you know, whatever. And for example, take this guy right here. Look at how much stuff he bought and look at this. Fireworks magazine. I don't know whoever this is, but whoever's selling this Amish looking magazine, you're signing up too. Okay, I'm going to be sending you an email. All right, there's a guy out there making these. Okay, already comes with the hoods, double locks. Everything you see out there fit in this. Let's take a look. Okay, the ATF was a little picky, but and honestly, it was reasonable because they said, and it's locked, I don't want to go in it, that these screws inside were exposed a little bit. They had to put a little something on them, and that's actually reasonable. He had it in another spot, and then he had to move it. There was some distance to that. So you actually probably should work with the local ATF guy to lay out your plans. Now, he did the license the hard way. Most people I tell get a license, do the easy way. Get the contingency and then the magazine. He did it with the magazine and everything. So when he went to buy this show, hey, Dave, I'm worried about how much explosive weight this holds. No, don't worry about the explosive weight. Make sure it'll fit, okay? It looked like a Rubik's Cube in there. but it all fit, and there was they worked on it to get it in there. But this will give you an idea of what it looks like if you have the money to buy it. Always had that Amish look to me. I don't know why, like an Amish magazine. Okay, you saw the magazine. All right, here's a guy that went from just enjoying consumer products. He knows all my videos. I'm really impressed. Way back, he knows all the guys, Randall, Joe. You know what to look for, what not to look for. We're joking about it all day. Took it up a notch. Look where he's at, putting on his big show. So hopefully I'm here to show it to him, and now he can maybe do it on his own with the Cobra or whatever. So tonight his family will come. People across the lake have nothing to do with this. This is all his show, so everything's a bonus for them over there. And we're actually right outside of Chicago. I won't tell you exactly where, but it should be kind of fun. All right, you saw the magazine. All right, everyone, catch you down the road. All right, everyone, it's before it gets dark, I want to introduce you to Patrick. Followed my videos. I'm going to be honest. He's been like quizzing me all day over watching my videos. And how long have you had your ATF license?
Actually, just since January. Okay. Been following your videos for several years and finally decided to take the plunge and actually do it.
And you have your own ATF license?
Yep.
You got the Cobras?
Yes, sir.
And you really have a nice piece of property here.
Thank you. I know you're blessed and fortunate.
You don't live here, but it's nice that we can come here.
Absolutely.
And shoot it. And you cut the grass better than I usually
cut the weeds.
Yeah, when I first looked at the shoot site, he just sent me a couple cell phone pictures. I'm like, man, I'm gonna have to make it the best. I come out here, it's like a dream. It's pretty nice.
Well, this is like a movie for me, because it's just cool having you here, Dave. I really appreciate you making the journey out here and helping us out and teaching us. And thank you. It means a lot.
Yeah, I enjoy seeing this because I feel like I'm doing something. That someone's watching my videos and they're like, I never hear from him. And all of a sudden it's like, boom. It's like, hey, I got a license. I got his magazine. He got everything. So, and I'm hoping it all goes off well tonight.
It will.
Your family will enjoy it. And the neighbors across the way are just used to seeing consumer stuff. So where did they get a load of this? And it's a great budget and it looks great.
Yeah.
And we worked all day. We thought it was going to rain, but it didn't. So now the temperature's dropping, and next thing you know, it'll be shoot time.
Yeah, all right, thank you so much, Dave. Really
appreciate
it.
Coming
thank
and
you.
The invite, and I'm having fun. All right, everyone, next shot should be showtime. I don't know if you can focus in on this. Here's the shoot sheet tonight, and here's the total. And if you look real close, stop the video. If you want, you'll see there's two of almost everything, which is kind of how we planned it. So there'll be one on each module. I had this on my website. Some people made some recommendations. Give you an idea what pricing looks like on 1-3 product, Dennis Lynch. So here it is. So if you bought that much in product, how much would a show sell for, is what you have to ask yourself. Probably at least three times that amount would be my guess, or close to that. They did this on their own. I told them to foil it. Here's what they came up with. Looks pretty damn good, huh? I probably should have put a second electric match in it, but I'm just going to go with one. Yeah, it's even holding with the wind a little bit. Okay. I'm going back to the hotel and get cleaned up. We get ready to come back. We're getting nice wind and hopefully no rain. All right, see you. A little competition. There's two things they like in Indiana: guns and fireworks. And only Arkansas beats them. We're actually in part of Indiana, outside of Chicago. All right, here it is. We're uncovering it. We had a threat of rain. Come down and show my cakes off, right? We're going to start the show off. When he knew I was coming, he bought my cakes to bring, to put here. The two that were out at the time. Pyro Dave, Academic Pyro. And you can see some of it, how we have it set up and staked. This is why when he went to purchase this show, I said, buy the longest electric match that you can. See why you want it? You could go around in a circle. And if we were shorter, we'd be pretty condensed. Oh, a helicopter. Probably gonna make a bunch of noise. Two of everything. Two, all the way through. Now these guys are not really experts. I mean, they're backyard guys. I told them to tape this for now, and it's all covered in fast foods. And look, it's windy, and it's doing a hell of a job. Here's what I did, something you may want to do. With being two of everything and one of this, to keep the continuity straight in my mind, I just put an electric match just hanging with nothing connected to it on this other module. I think that's hit number 9. So I just have over here on the second module, just an electric match, number 9. By the time we go into the third and final module, that's when the boom's going to start. I mean, I got a little bit of boom in the show, but it's going to be boom, 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 boom. And then finally over here. Now, this is like a real professional tarp here. And what we're going to do is I have 2 hits on this. 2, and I have it double fused in some places. Be sure it goes. So I got number 10 connected on module 3 and number 10 connected over here on module 3. I'll give you a little peek at it. See, it's going to come in right here with the port. And then it just starts jumping around how I fused it. But like as we get close to the end, I'm going to send 2 guys out, pull the tarp, because we want to protect our finale. Now we're seeing people across the lake. They're going to get a free show tonight. And they're starting to put their picnic chairs out. Now they know Pat shooting this in prior years with just consumer stuff. So they'll probably really appreciate this. Okay, here's the audience. And we're hoping, we're going to watch how the fallout goes. And if we need to, we'll move them. But it was real windy, and I said, usually this is how this goes, you guys that do shows. It gets real windy, and then all of a sudden when night falls, the wind kind of starts to settle. It's already starting to settle. Although if you look up at the tree, you'll see it's still blowing a little bit. And unfortunately, it's blowing towards the audience. So I hope we don't have to move them. But we're going to wait a little bit longer, a little bit darker. All right, everyone, take you over, show you Pyro headquarters. All right, here it is right here, Pyro headquarters. 1 Cobra module. There are 6 total Cobra modules out there we're gonna use tonight. So that goes to show you can get by with, you know, I have 3, that's all I have. Pat has actually more than 6, but we're only using 6. And we're gonna break it in tonight. He said he synced them all. I checked the very first one we fired up, and it showed continuity. We run around, we took some of the bags off, checked continuity. So the rest is just waiting for showtime. If you were on my Facebook, I was following some of it as we went through the day. Hope you enjoyed those pictures. And that's it. Now we just sit and wait. Okay, we're firing it up. And we should have 6 modules out there. Let it run through its test. Okay, I'm showing 6. Okay, now I'm gonna run through the continuity. Module 1, module 2, module 3. Hey, Patrick. Where's Patrick?
Right here.
Pat. Right
there. Hey. I like to put this up high in case I accidentally bump it.
Something wrong?
I'm waiting for you to start the show.
Yeah, we're good whenever confirmed.
All right, you can tell.
Light it up.
Let me arm it. I should arm all six. Let me make sure. All six are turned to arm. Let me run this down a little dimmer. It down. All right, guys, everybody ready?
You guys ready?
Okay, we're going to start with my two picks when I press number one. Here we go. Module one. It's a hell of a job, man. Hell of a job. Let it burn, let it burn.
Is that normal?
Yeah, let it burn. We have some stuff on fire up here, but we're really not too concerned about it. Now, that's another reason why you don't want to be too close to the cobra. You want long electric mats. Last one. My boys here ready to pull the tarp when I tell them. Everything's rolling nice. And the wind is just not, look how nice that wind is. One more here, and then we're going to start working into the canal. Let's see what this is. I'm not going to fire anything while they're out there.
You got to be safe.
Yeah.
What happened?
They're too new at it. I want to let them go and pull.
There's a tarp?
Yeah, I got to uncover a finale.
Oh, no.
The finale's coming.
You guys all right?
That's the two.
Okay, back up. I'm building into a slide. Thank you.
eyes on him, man.
There's no more, buddy. That was it.
Is that where more is?
Hey, everyone, I'm going to cut for a minute, and we're going to go out and clear the guns. So I hope you enjoyed it. Lynch Import Products is really great. Patrick, it's a pleasure to be here. All right, now we're going to see it's all burning. We don't care. A couple things I think didn't fire, so which is common. We're going to go check it out.
You ever seen anything like that?
Me? Yeah. I told you it would be good. We'll put the place on the map, I told you. All right, we're coming out to check. Rich.
Yes.
Hit the top of the cakes to see what didn't fire.
Okay.
Before we even walk up there. Like, you'll know because the labels. All right, here's something that didn't go. Oh, no. What didn't go?
Okay. All right, we're checking things right now. Okay. All right.
Did anything?
No.
All the tops gone?
Yeah,
I don't see.
Yeah. Okay.
This one's good.
All right, somebody want to go in, shut the Cobra off?
Yep.
Everything went.
Here, can you take this flare?
Yes. God, Dave, that was one of the coolest shows I think I've ever seen.
I told you guys would like it. Yeah, I'm glad. Yeah.
Now, did you help Pat pick that stuff out?
Should I take it out of here yet, Dave, or just turn it off?
Yeah, I mean, you want to just turn it off for now, and it won't come back.
Okay.
Let's clear all these guns.
Okay.
Now, here's what you do is you shine your light on this. It looked like all the consumer stuff went.
Yep.
Okay. I could swear there's a few things that didn't go.
Because it looked like the cakes are firing by themselves.
All right. Well, let's do it like we wired it. Let's go over to one.
Okay.
One and one. I'm going to see what kind of fuse job you guys did, too.
Yeah, I want to
nice.
See
it. Real nice.
Lost one, too.
Okay, just shine on top of the cakes. Anything not fired. Oh, my God, we got them all.
Is it okay if I go in and turn it off?
Yeah, go ahead, sneak in there, shut it down. Everything gone? I think in module 2 we may have missed something.
Oh, nope, right here.
Where? Only.
Did it go through?
Yeah, it went through.
Okay, no, we're good.
Okay, let's move it over. How about this baby? This consumer one?
Yeah, we're good.
Good. All right, now module 2. Boy, module 1's on fire. This one is like calmed down.
Everything went so far?
Yeah, this is module.
You want to shut it down?
Sure.
Yeah.
It all went.
Good.
That at the end, Dave, that was unbelievable.
I made it intense for
that
you.
That was unbelievable.
I told you. That's why I told you to get out there and get that tarp off.
Oh, yeah.
Because I knew I could salvage the whole show at that point.
Do you want to keep going on this before we go to
No, let's do it in order, guys, like
okay,
we wired it.
Okay,
this is 2, right?
That's 3. But
all right, okay. Where's tiers 2? How we looking? Good?
Looking good.
All right, shut it down.
Those cakes were unbelievable.
They're nice, aren't they?
Unbelievable.
Okay, 3. You know, I could swear there was something that didn't go.
Maybe some burned quicker than the others. I don't know.
All right, just switch that key to off.
Got it.
All right. Okay, over to here. All right, now I'm going to see the wire job you guys did.
Oh, yeah.
Look how those mortars bounced out of there.
Mm-hmm.
No, don't look over top. Just,
no, yeah.
You know what? Did it all go?
No, there's 2 right there.
Careful, guys.
Yeah, yeah. Watch setting it on the ground. See that hot ash?
Yeah, that's not good.
Just set them on top.
Just don't even do there, anything with
yeah.
Just
where's the other one?
There's one right here.
There's two right here.
All right, see, you know, here's the downside of having a big rack. Now you got to reach in it. You know what? This rack ain't going nowhere tonight. Just let it sit.
No, right. Yeah, we're not messing with
yeah. it. Yeah, okay. See, this is like people want to build a big rack. Like, say a shell didn't go way up there. Look at all this shit you got to reach over.
Yeah, here's mm-hmm. one that didn't
Careful,
go.
Careful, Dan.
Yeah, don't get
yeah,
over
just
top.
Just leave it
yeah.
alone.
All right, let's go to the next one. Where's the next one at? Two. Here. This one.
I think we checked this one, didn't we?
Yeah, I checked them.
It's good? Did you shut it down?
I thought I did, but...
Yeah. You know what? Everything went.
Uncle Ronnie said it was a half-hour show.
Really?
That's what he said.
It may have been. Hey,
that's your PVC.
Oh, look
it
at that.
It blew the big rack.
Look at that. Good look thing we didn't
wait
use
minute,
it.
Wait a minute. Something blew.
Look, Dave, there's something smoking right here.
Yeah, that's not... That's an ash.
Something blew in the inside the tube.
Here, let me get a light on this.
Right here.
Oh, you know what? Here.
Yeah, Dave was right about that, huh?
I told you I'm thinking, and there's something that's hanging. I could see it. Mm-hmm. Here, let's look over here.
Goody.
Here, check right here first. Yeah. Okay, it blew. Wait a minute. All those mortars are gone. That whole row of mortars is gone.
What's that tail?
No, wait a minute.
There's just one.
To do that, but.
Yeah.
I don't know. We didn't put any in that rack.
No, so we didn't put any in that rack.
It just, hey, let me see. Let me
maybe
see
it
that.
Exploded while it came out.
Hold on, man. Let me look.
Yes, there was one that blew low.
That's probably what it was then.
How in the hell did it blow that mortar? That mortar blew out of there.
We didn't have anything in there.
No, we didn't have anything.
This is the one that we didn't want to use.
Right. Correct. We didn't use it.
Yeah. But how did that mortar come out of there?
I'm thinking maybe it caught over there.
I have no idea. It was far enough away. Something blew up low, I know, at one point.
It's still smoking. Stay back, man.
Yeah. Okay. But, I mean, only one shell didn't go, right?
Yep.
That's what it looks like.
Okay, here you go.
That's pretty good, huh?
Hell yeah.
What about this one? That's just an ash.
That's an ash. How in the hell did that mortar blow out of there?
I can't believe that.
Man. And there was nothing in it.
There's nothing in
no.
it.
And nothing. The next one didn't blow apart.
Yeah, it was the one right there on that corner.
Yeah.
That's weird. Something could
have
got tangled and...
Who the hell knows? Or the intensity of the whole thing bounced
oh,
it
man,
out of there.
That was intense. No, no. Now, to me, why do you need to get any bigger than threes? I mean, that's plenty good.
For out here, yeah.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah. Okay. Here, you know what? Just set this kind of like on top. Like not in the pipe.
Like right here?
No.
Oh.
Not like this. Let's okay. leave it like
gotcha.
That. Okay. All right.
So
okay,
pretty
folks.
Much everything went.
That's it. Now the rest is get the Cobra modules and clean it up. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next video.